Here's another example. The limit as h goes to 0 of the square root of 1 plus h minus 1 over h. Okay, so let's start by trying to split up the quotient. So what happens? On top, I would get the limit as h goes to 0 of the square root of 1 plus h minus 1. And then the denominator, the limit as h goes to 0 of h. Okay, so let's try and picture what would happen if I worked through the steps and was plugging in these zeros. So on the top, I'm going to get the square root of 1 plus 0 minus 1. So that's going to give me 0, right? And then on the bottom, of course, that's going to give me 0 as well. The limit as h goes to 0 of h is just 0. Okay, so I see that I'm getting 0 over 0, right? So just as a quick review, remember that 0 over 0, whenever we see that form, when we're taking a limit, we know that we need to do a little bit more algebra to figure out the answer. Now also, that's different from if you get a number over 0, which tells you there's an asymptote at that particular value you're looking at. Now we'll talk a lot more about asymptotes in the future, but this is just something to keep in mind as we work through these. Okay, so this needs some sort of algebraic method to simplify it in a way that's going to get us away from that 0 over 0 form. So there's a method called multiplying by the conjugate that's often very helpful when you have square roots like this. So let me show you how to do that. Okay, so let's go from the original form we had. So the limit as h goes to 0 of the square root of 1 plus h minus 1 over h. Okay, now I'm going to multiply the top and bottom by the same thing. Now it's important that I multiply the top and bottom by the same thing because by doing that I'm essentially multiplying by 1 and therefore not changing the problem. And what I'm going to multiply by is the conjugate of the numerator. Okay, and what the conjugate is I'm going to keep the square root 1 plus h, but I'm going to change this to plus 1. And you'll see when we work this out that that's just going to help that square root cancel out really nicely. And then, like I said, we need to multiply by the same thing in the bottom so that we're not altering the problem. Okay, so I'm multiplying by the conjugate. And now I just have to do the algebra. Okay, so it's going to be a little messy. But basically, I'm going to want to FOIL the top. Okay, so if I FOIL the top, I get the square root of 1 plus h squared. And then that's going to be plus the square root of 1 plus h minus the square root of 1 plus h minus 1. That's on the top. And then in the bottom, I just have h times the quantity square root of 1 plus h plus 1. Okay, so now I think you see why multiplying by the conjugate is so useful. Because look what happens in the top. I've got the square root of 1 plus h squared. Okay, so I've got a square root squared, so I'm just left with 1 plus h. And now look, I've got plus root 1 plus h minus root 1 plus h. So those completely cancel out. And then I have minus 1. Okay, and I'm going to keep the denominator like this for now. So h times the quantity 1 plus h plus 1. Okay, so what happens in the top? So, of course, the 1's go away. And I'm just left with h over h times the square root of 1 plus h minus 1. Okay, now we see that even there's another thing that cancels out, because I have a factor of h in the bottom and in the top. Okay, great. So now I'm just left with the limit as h goes to 0 of 1 over the square root of 1 plus h minus 1. Okay, so that simplified a lot. So now let's try using our limit laws to solve this. So I'm going to split up the quotient, and I'm going to have the limit as h goes to 0 of 1 on the top, and on the bottom, the limit as h goes to 0 of the square root of 1 plus h minus 1. Okay, and now on the bottom, I'm going to split that up further. Okay, I just realized I have a small mistake in my work. So go back a few steps. On the denominator here, this should be a plus. I changed that to a minus accidentally, but that should be a plus on the bottom. So go back and fix that in your notes. Plus here and plus here. Okay, so like I said, I want to split up that denominator one more step. So the limit is h goes to 0 of 1 on the top. And then on the bottom, limit as h goes to 0 of the square root of 1 plus h plus the limit as h goes to 0 of 1. Okay, and then I'm going to work inside that square root. I guess I can go ahead and simplify this top, right? Because the limit as h goes to 0 of 1 is just 1. Okay, and I'm going to move my limit inside the square root on the denominator. So that's going to be the square root. And I'll go ahead and split up the sum as well. So the limit as h goes to 0 of 1 plus the limit as h goes to 0 of h plus, and then the limit as h goes to 0 of 1 is 1, like we just said. Okay, so 1 on the top still. Under that square root, I'm going to have 1 plus 0 plus 1. Okay, so the square root of 1 plus 0 is just 1. So this gives me 1 half is my final answer. Okay, quick summary. So we came across a different kind of problem that gave us 0 over 0, which told us we needed to do a little bit more algebra. Now, the new trick that we used in this case was to multiply by the conjugate on the top and the bottom, which often works out very nicely for square roots. And that let a lot of things simplify, and then we were able to use our limit laws to finish solving the problem.